Powers of hypnosis, guys. It's really fantastic. Really, really helps you guys completely relax, completely relax. So, I didn't have a chance to meet a volunteer like that. Mark, my name is Rick, and you're listening to my voice only, for the remainder period of time. Mark, like that, what I want you to do is I want you to slowly come up, and I want you to look at me and open your eyes. How you doing? Nice to meet you. How are you? Feeling the benefits of the hypnosis? Or you really like it there? Yeah. Very, very relaxing, isn't it? Excellent. Great. So, actually, I'll tell you what. I mean, I'm actually from New Hampshire, okay? I'm actually down here visiting Mike and everything, having some fun and everything. And one of the things which we like to do, obviously, having fun with different people and everything, what we also like to do is one of my fun favorite things here. For example, in other words, you're feeling really comfortable in that chair right about now, right? Okay? So, what actually, what's something that's going to be interesting is you'll notice, actually, right about now, when I actually start to shake your hand, what's going to happen is, and the audience will notice it too, that no matter how hard you try, you're actually not going to be able to sit up to get out of your chair. Okay? So, actually, kind of a pretty fun thing. So, let's give that a try. So, go ahead and shake my hand nice and firm like that. Actually, try to stand up right about now. Try to stand up. Try to stand up. Try to stand up. Try to stand up. Nope. Just like that. And release. And stop. There we go. Good job, man. So, that kind of gives you an idea, guys. As far as all of them together, you just can't do it. Just can't do it. There you go. Hey, Mark, let me ask you this. Are you a sports car guy? Are you a sports car guy like that? Do you like driving out like that? As far as sports car, any particular favorite car you like? What kind of car do you drive?
I drive an SUV.
You drive an SUV? All right. What kind of SUV is it?
Mercury Mariner.
Mercury Mariner. Okay. Good car. Anyone like that? You know what? I'm a classic car buff, and I also like, you know, a good sports car. Like that. If you could drive any particular sports car, anything in particular you like to drive?
67 Ford Mustang.
67 Mustang. All right, the guy's talking my language. I had a 73 Vet, the 454, and I miss that car. So I believe the car came from Miami. That car's probably back down in Miami right about now. But something kind of cool, nothing like that. What I want you to do is I want you to imagine right now behind the wheel of that 67, okay? So what I want you to do is I actually want you to just close your eyes and just relax and sleep. Like every time I touch your head, your shoulders, or any particular part as far as your arms or your knees or your legs, you're just going to put you back into that relaxed state, like just completely relaxing. So I want you to imagine right now, and just to think if you will, that you're behind the wheel of that nice 67 and just really, really feeling that car. Matter of fact, imagine if you will, For example, you got the keys to that car. Maybe you're sticking the keys into the ignition of that car. And maybe what we'll do is we're going to fire that boy up right about now. So, just what we're going to do is imagine reaching in your pocket, grabbing those keys, reaching in your pocket, just grabbing those keys. That's right. Grabbing them in, you're sticking them in the ignition. Now, let's go ahead, let's continue to stick them in the ignition, make sure the doors are locked, firing that bad boy up here, and just kind of just want to vroom.
There we go, all right, there we go. All right, sounds good, all right.
So you're actually behind the wheel of that car, just feeling it. So now what I'm going to do is I want you to imagine, for example, okay, I got to ask you this part. Is it a stick or is it an automatic? It's an automatic. Okay. All right. I'm a manual shift person myself here, but that's okay. So I want you to imagine, for example, right now that car isn't like that. So when it's nice, it was completely relaxed. And what you're going to do is I want you to imagine just kind of putting that car in gear right about now and firing that bad boy up like that. Boom. Okay. Like that. Just hey, give it a little gas. Give it a little gas. Boom. 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 Moving right along like that. You're tearing down the road. 20 miles an hour. 30 miles an hour. 40 miles an hour. 50 miles an hour. Oh, left turn. Turn as fast as you can. Left turn. Left turn. Left turn. Whoa. Okay. All right. Bring it back straight up. Bring it back straight up. Straight away. Straight away. Here comes the straight away. Moving right along. All right. Turn as fast as you can. Right turn, there you go. Good job. All right. Bring it straight back up, okay? All right. Oh, we got some guy who's trying to tailgate you like that. Now, hit that gas to say goodbye, dude. Like that, just gonna totally fly away. Moving right along. All right, he's disappearing in the dust. Left turn, coming up again. Left turn, left turn, left turn, left turn, left turn, left turn, left turn. Good job, left turn. All right, keep it on straight away again. Straight away again. Excellent. All right. Keep it okay. Moving right along. All right. Excellent. There you go. Okay, here comes another quick right turn. Right turn. Right turn. Right turn. Now, left turn. Left turn. Left turn. Left turn. Left turn. Left turn. There you go. All right. Very good. Keep it in control, dude. All right. There you go. Moving right along. Wow. I'm surprised. Look how fast he's going, guys. Making some noise for him. He's holding that baby right on the road. Good job. All right. All right. Ooh, good thing we haven't seen anything like that as far as the management like that. Oh, okay. Hold on. Did I just see something hiding on the side of the road over there? Hopefully I didn't. Okay, like that. Keep it going on the straightaway. Keep it going. Moving right along. Good thing we haven't seen any cops yet, like, because we certainly don't want to get pulled over. Yeah, let's roll that window down. Get some nice fresh air going there. All right. Good job.
All right. Hold on 1 second here. All right. You know who's going to come through the window. Shut her down. Shut her down. Roll down the window. He's going to come up. The window's right. All right. But now, all of a sudden, my name's changed to Officer Smith, and I'm with the Lakeland Police Department. And, sir, I need your license and registration, please. Can you reach in your pocket and give me your license and registration, sir? Okay. There you go. Thank you, sir. All right. Very good. Okay. Let's take a look and see what we got here. All right. Okay. One dispatch. Yeah. Okay. Mark, what's up, Ken? Yeah. Can you do a background on him for me? Thank you, sir. All right. Okay, good. All right. Watch Mark, why don't you just relax right there? I'll be right back with you. Hold on 1 second. All right. Dispatch? Okay. Thank you. All right. Sounds good. Okay. All right. Sir. Kind of going a little bit fast there. Trying to get to someplace real fast. Can you tell me a little bit what's going on? Why are you going so fast?
I'm just putting your engine in this thing. Just trying it out, officer.
Just trying it out. Okay. Well, she goes pretty fast for you there, doesn't she?
She does a good job.
That was a good job. There you go. That's okay. Mark, got to ask you a question here. When I call back to my dispatch and everything like that and everything and checking on some things on the license here, is there any reason why I shouldn't give you a ticket?
Because I'm a nice guy?
If I heard that all the time as far as a nice guy, you realize how many tickets I wouldn't be getting, the police department would go broke. All right. So, give me one more reason why I shouldn't give you a ticket.
I'll give you $20.
Oh, bribery. There we go. That always works. I'll tell you what, Mike. You know what? I used to have a sports car by myself with that as well. You know what? Ladies and gentlemen, you think we should give him a break? Should we go and let him go?
Yeah.
Let him go? Okay, well, I'm going to tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to be a good guy, and I'll let you go, and he'll let you off the verbal warning, like that and everything. I know you like the 67, just back down a little bit. Here's your wallet back again. I appreciate it. You can put that back in your pocket. Folks, give her a nice round of applause. Great job. Very good. That's how you do it. All right. Excellent job. All right. Excellent. Okay, so let's go ahead and kind of clear our mind out of that marking like that. So now what I want you to do like that, just completely concentrate. When I touch you on the shoulder, I want you to go to sleep and just relax. And just completely relax, okay? I'm going to hold you on the ground. Just like so. Very good. Just relax. Just let yourself drift too far in the water. Okay. So let's kind of change gears here a little bit, guys. Okay, imagine if you will, such a gorgeous day out. I will say as far as being down here in Florida, it's been so beautiful in the time I've been here. So much to the point that I actually wanted to go, maybe going up to like maybe a nice skate park, maybe with a couple friends of mine and go out and have a nice picnic. And, you know, maybe just maybe pack a lunch, maybe some sandwiches, maybe some drinks, whatever, just kind of kick back and relax and everything. So we're going to go over to the park and we're just going to kick back and relax and everything. So I want you to imagine right about now, if you will, Mark, just imagine that you're just at the park and we're just completely, just totally chilling out. And we packed a nice picnic basket and everything. We've got some nice sandwiches. We've got our drinks. Everything's tasting really good. So we're going to reach in then. I want you to imagine, if you will, right about now, Mark. I want you to kind of sit a bit more upright, if you would. Okay. So imagine, if you will, you're reaching in that picnic basket. Maybe you're just kind of grabbing that favorite sandwich. Open it up here. There you go. Reach in. Grab that sandwich. We are so hungry. There we go. Go ahead. Take a nice big bite of that bad boy. There you go. Sounds good. All right. Yeah, not to ask you a question with your mouth chewing food here. What kind of sandwich do you like?
That's a top round roast beef from Publix.
Top round roast beef from Publix. I like it. Good. Sounds good. All right. Good. What do we got to wash it down with?
Crystal Light.
Crystal Light. Very good. Sounds good. Very tastes good. I like that. Reaching in there, just enjoying that. Like that. Just relaxing and just enjoying and eating that sandwich, drinking that and everything, and just relaxing, kicking back and enjoying and everything. And you know what? Wait a minute. Uh-oh. I knew it was too good to be true. All right, we're sitting here eating all that stuff here. You know what? All of a sudden, we never seems to fail. We always get those mosquitoes that just happen to come out. You know, oh, here he is. That bug's flying around again. Swat that bad boy away. Swat that bug. There you go. Moving around, left and right, left and right, left and right, moving along, ladies and gentlemen. All talk about self-abuse. There we go. Okay, moving on. Right that bad way. Okay, see if you get swat. 1, 2, 3, stop. Let that go. You got him, you got him. Give a nice round of applause. Good job, dude. Very good. All right, you got that one. Well, maybe he's not. He's still alive. He's still alive. He's still swatting. Let that swat him again. Try and get him again. Like that. Man, oh, man, he's biting like crazy. Oh, you got him. You got him. You got him. You got him. Give him a nice round of applause. Good job, guys. Very good. Good job, Mark. Excellent. I like it. All right. All right. Very good. Nice. Just kick back, relax. All right. Just feel so good. Just sleep. And just relax. And just completely drift and let yourself drift and flow in and out. And slowly coming back to normal. His mug is gone. Your picnic is all gone. We had a pretty good time up to the mosquito. That's okay. We're just relaxing now. Just letting ourselves go. And just completely drifting and floating and melting. Just letting yourself completely go. Matter of fact, every now and then, you know, sometimes when you're just relaxed, sometimes you get so relaxed. Maybe you ever had a dream, or maybe like sometimes in the dream you might have heard maybe some voices, or maybe you were hearing something that was happening during that dream. So, what I want you to imagine right about now, Mark, would be a circumstance where maybe you're sitting there and maybe you're just relaxing in the chair that you're in, and any time that I happen to talk in a voice,
God help him, so soft like this,
you're going to think that that voice is actually coming from your pockets in your pants, and you have to try and find out where the voice is. So, just imagine, once again, when you hear that sound, as far as the voice,
talking like this from your deep voice,
you're going to think it's coming actually from your pants pocket. Right. All right. 1, 2, open your eyes. All right. Very good. Okay. So, folks, have a good one tonight in Winter Circle. Have a good time. Just there, kick back, relax. Very good. Yeah, I like having a good time, too. I was talking with my friends over here. Mike was over here. And a couple of other people's over here. And I was actually talking to a friend of mine.
Well, it's pretty over here, so it's funny. I'm recording your pocket support. And it is dancing the lines of them. I'm talking to you in my from the pocket, but you have no idea where it is whatsoever. What is it?
Mark, turn the lights going on. Why are you trying to come out with that?
I can't hear where that voice is coming
from. What voice? What are you talking about? We're saying you were just shooting the breeze and all the guests here like that at the Winter Circle. Like,
oh, sorry.
It was like that? It was like what?
No, something
like that. Really? Okay. That's weird. Huh.
I don't hear it. I just have to hear the voice coming from
your
head.
It's funny. What are you talking about? Look, careful. We don't want you to fall. It's in there. He says he's here. Is anybody else hearing this voice I'm talking about?
No.
Dude, I know what you're talking about. That's alright, that's okay. Well, that's alright. Well, maybe it is. I don't know. We'll go ahead and we'll take a look at it. Like,
maybe you want to just lie in front of the phone. Just like this. I'm going to go on and go on for years. And every time you just come looking at the phone, you can talk about the voice.
I don't know what he's doing, guys. That's okay. Somewhere there's a mysterious voice, but that's okay. Give a nice round of applause. Having a good old time with that. Good job. That's excellent. Alright. Sounds good. Alright. Okay, you know what? I can't believe when I came down here and everything as far as I packed all my stuff in my suitcase. I packed my sneakers, and I packed a couple of other shoes, and I didn't pack any sandals whatsoever, because I figured I would just be able to kick back and relax, because that way I would have had some nice, quiet sandals. I actually had my thicker shoes on and everything like that, and I was figuring it would be so nice and everything. But I just can't help but notice that, for example, Mike, that you got some of those sneakers you're wearing are pretty cool, actually. So what kind of those are? What kind of sneakers are those?
Actually, they're Pro-Pay.
Okay, cool. All right, they're pretty comfortable, aren't they? They're really? Excellent, okay. Well, you know what's going to be really interesting? Could I ask you to just take off one of your shoes? Just one of the sneakers? Or just take off either one is fine, left or right, doesn't make a difference. Okay, sounds good and everything. So now what's going to happen is you're going to notice that something really, really interesting is going to happen. Because what's going to happen is, as soon as you actually, you're going to hear a sound, and believe it or not, it's not a shoe, but believe it or not, it's actually a shoe phone. It's actually a shoe phone. What is it? Oh, they're calling you right now. Go ahead, pick up the call. They don't see me take the call. Okay, try and talk to them. Hello? Hello? They're right there. They're there. They're not there. Like that, something? Oh, jeez, I don't know. You must be hitting the wrong button or something like that. All right, they must have hung up. It's not ringing anymore. No. Wow, that's weird. Why in the world would your shoe be a phone? That doesn't make any sense. I don't know. You know what? I think I know what happened. Actually, you know what? It wasn't a shoe foam. Actually, the shoe is actually a nice, beautiful little puppy. A nice little beautiful puppy dog, okay? Why don't you take your puppy dog and just kind of hold your puppy in your lap and just maybe pet the puppy and everyone. Just pet your favorite dog and like, just so nice. Beautiful, beautiful dog. I really like that. That's such a, why don't you give him a nice hug? Because you'll hug him with that. Hold him close and hug him. Like, that's such a beautiful dog here. Like that. Such a nice dog. Yeah. I gotta ask, what's doggy's name?
Gravy.
Gravy. Gravy's such a beautiful doggy. Oh, nice. Look at that. Isn't Gravy so nice? I like that. Well, yeah, so right. What kind of food does Gravy like to eat?
Pedigree.
Pedigree. All right. Good. All right. Excellent. Gorgeous. Beautiful dog there. So nice, so nice. Just relaxing, playing with Gravy, you know, just petting him and just relaxing and kicking back and everything. You know what? Wouldn't it be cool if we took Gravy to the park with us and everything, okay? And we're sitting here, okay? Here's what I want you to do. I want you to put Gravy down here for just a quick second. Just set it right on the side here. We'll get Gravy here in just a second. Here. But you know what? Here's what I want to do. We're going to set Gravy over here. But you know what? We've got a friend of ours who let us borrow another dog. And this is Fluffy, okay? Fluffy's a nice, beautiful dog. And your friend actually let you borrow it because I wasn't able to dog walk Fluffy today, but if you can actually help me out, we're actually going to walk Fluffy and take him out here. So here's what we're going to do. I want you to imagine like that Fluffy's actually going to go with it. Fluffy is a retriever and loves to retrieve. That's right, Fluffy, that's right. Ooh, Fluffy's over there. There you go. So here's what I want you to do. I want you to imagine, for example, right now, that you're going to stick in your hand, okay? And what we're going to do is Fluffy is going to go get the stick. So get ready. On the count of three, we're going to toss that stick, and Fluffy's going to go get it. Ready? One, two, three, throw it. Good job. Okay, Fluffy, go get it. Go get it, Fluffy. Go get it, go get it, Fluffy. Go, 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 go. All right, Fluffy, bring the stick back. Bring the stick back. Oh, there you go. Good job. All right. All right, you got to stick it again. All right, let's go ahead and try that again. Let's go for a little more distance this time. Ready on the count of three. Throw that. One, two, three. There we go. All right, going all the way back out there. Fluffy, go get it, go get it, go get it, go get it, go, 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 go. All right, Fluffy, coming back. Get it. There we go. All right, good job. Okay, all right, good. Okay. Let's see how good you really are. And now what I want you to do is let's launch that stick as fast and as far as you can. Okay, on the count of three. One, two, three. Do that. All the way out there, all the way out there. Oh, wait, no. Wait a minute. Fluffy. Fluffy didn't get hurt, did he? No. Oh, wait a minute. No, Fluffy actually didn't get hurt. No. Is Fluffy okay with that? No, believe it or not, Superman just happened to land and stop traffic just in time so Fluffy didn't get hit. Good job. Thank you so much, Superman. Can you believe that? Superman actually stopped him. Like that, do you want to say thanks to Superman? So just tell him how much you appreciate him.
Thanks, Clark.
Thanks, Clark. Okay, there we go. Good job, man. Okay, Fluffy, come on back over, Fluffy. Like, oh, Superman's actually going to fly, Fluffy. Here you go, here's Fluffy. Okay, all right. Thank you, that's right. Okay, thank you so much, Superman. Bye, see you later. Shh. Did I like that? Give him a nice round of applause. Good job, guys. There you go. Fluffy's back. So nice. So nice. Awesome. All right. Back to happy times. And just kick back and relax and like that and everything like that. We had such a fun day in the park and we're playing with the dogs. There you go. How's Gravy doing over here? Gravy. Gravy's like that. Here, like that. So go ahead, like that. Maybe get... Give Gravy a nice hug, like that, and like that, and like that. You know what? Give Gravy a kiss, too, as well. Look at that kiss. Oh, that's right. Kiss is Gravy. There you go. Such a beautiful dog. All right. So here's what we're going to do, actually. I want you to imagine, if you will, that even though Gravy's having a good time, you're having a good time. I want you to imagine like that when you were back when you were a young child, Mark. When you were a young child, maybe about 4 years old, a really, really happy time in your life. A really happy time in your life, okay? So, what I want you to do is imagine that time. Imagine yourself, if you will. We're going to set Gravy over here for just a quick second. Stay Gravy. Okay, good, okay. So I want you to just imagine, if you will, that you're actually getting younger in your body and just slowly going back and just actually regressing back to the age when you were 4 years old and it was a really, really happy time. Happy, 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 fun, fun time. Happy, happy, fun, fun time. so much fun and everything. Why? Because it's your birthday today. Like, then you're 4 years old. Give yourself a round of applause. It's your birthday. So nice. Folks, we should sing a happy birthday to him, shouldn't we? Help us out.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Mark. Happy birthday to you.
All right. Happy birthday, Mark. Great. Good job. That's right. Now, something that's interesting. We don't have the cake is on its way, Mark, and the cake hasn't gone here yet. But you know what we did? We got some ice cream for you like that. So, yeah. I think I got you. You're four. That's right. You are 4 years old. That's right. Absolutely. I think we got your favorite ice cream. Which one was it again? What's your favorite ice cream again?
Chocolate.
That's right. We got vanilla chocolate and strawberry. Because we know you liked a couple of them. Look at that. Chocolate's your favorite flavor. Matter of fact, I got an ice cream cone here for you. Want to try the chocolate ice cream? This is all for you. There you go. Go ahead and lick your ice cream cone. There we go. Oh, it's so delicious. Ian, leaning the ice cream cone. Just licking the ice cream cone. Licking. You know what? Some of that ice cream is starting to drip down onto your wrist and onto your arm and everything like that. So make sure you don't miss any. Make sure you get it off the bowl, okay? Yeah, lick it off the wrist and like that, okay? Lick it off your arm. Send us on the arm, too, as well. On the arm, don't forget. Lick it off the arm, okay? Excellent. There you go. Licking on it, working like that, and everything. You know what? Most of the ice cream cone is gone. Why don't you just eat the whole ice cream cone? Just plug it in there. There you go. All right. So that's good. Oh, my God. Oh, what happened? Brain freeze. That hurts so much. Brain freeze. Oh my God, what do you do? Oh my God. But you know what? You had a happy birthday. You had such a fun time. The brain freeze is slowly working its way up like that. It's slowly coming back here. Here we go. On the count of three, that's what I imagine. It's 1, 2, 3, sleep. And just relax. Just relaxing. And do a good job. Nice. Happy birthday to him. Folks, I hope you enjoyed it. I'm going to bring the right phone back over to Mike. Like that, we'll continue the show. Hope you guys had a great time. Maybe some noise for Mark as well. All right. Just really relax, Mark. And just enjoy it. Just relax wherever you are. Mike is going to come back up. He's going to be the next voice from here. And just make yourself nice and comfortable on that chair. And that's where that's completely going.
Yeah.
Right. Sounds good. Ladies and gentlemen, back to Mike Van Omar.
All right, guys. Give us a round of applause for Ron Lewis. Everyone formally introduced. Rick Andrews all the way from New Hampshire to come down and play with you guys tonight. Okay, give it up for Rick. The amazing Cheryl Q from Miami, she's sitting up here. She's also a hypnotist, but she's kind enough to let us get up here and play tonight. So we appreciate you. We're trying out some new stuff. Rick has some new skits and everything. We want to do it in front of a live audience. Bill, wherever Bill is and everything, I want to personally thank Bill for letting us come down and just hanging out and play and have fun with it, okay? Very, very good. For Mr. Mark, boy, he looks comfy. We'll just leave him. What do you think?
Yeah.
Huh? I'm not the other hypnotist.
Okay, sure.
Mark, go ahead and open your eyes. Sit up straight for me, my friend. All right. Good job, man. Good job. Somebody took your shoe off, man. What happened? Don't you hate when that happens? Make sure you tie it up real good so you don't trip. Cool. That's a little sample of hypnosis. We're not quite done yet, but you know, we can't make you do anything you want to do. And the reason why his shoe was a thong is because he agreed to come up here and have fun. And the way the subconscious mind works is, okay, that's safe, that's fun. If I were to take him, because he is definitely hypnotized right now, I'm sure you would agree. If I were to say, okay, go up the bar and bring me out all the money, he wouldn't do it, okay? Anything what? You wouldn't do in your conscious state, you're not going to do under hypnosis. If I were to read to any of you, or even my buddy here up on stage, if I was to read a paragraph, you could probably repeat 2 or 3 sentences. Right now, if I were to read a paragraph, this man up here could probably repeat the whole paragraph because your mind is so much sharper. Okay? Anything else we want to do? Any other fun? We don't want to take advantage of it too much. You have an evil mind, though, right?
Oh, I know. I do have
a evil mind. We're going to wrap it up and let you guys get back to our regular schedule program. Very, very good. Appreciate you coming up. Very, very good. Doing very good. All right. And that's how it works very, very easy. Now, what we're going to do, Mr. Park, all the suggestions that we've given you tonight, all the suggestions that we've given you are now removed. They have no effect on you whatsoever. Whenever you hear a siren, you won't freak out about a police, okay? And all the other skits that we've given you, all those suggestions now are totally removed from you. And what we're going to do is we're going to give you new positive thoughts to take with you that will last as long as you need them to, okay? Not just tonight, but in everyday life. And the positive suggestions I want to give you are, one, when you go home tonight and you go to sleep at your regular bedtime, you're going to realize that you're going to be so relaxed that you're going to fall right asleep. You're going to sleep the whole night through. And if you do have to wake up, make a bathroom call or something, as soon as your head hits that pillow, you'll fall fast asleep again. Not your head, if you understand. Very, very good. So we're going to give you a good night's sleep. When you awaken in the morning, you're going to be, as they say, bright-eyed and bushy-tailed. You're going to be feeling energetic. You're going to have more energy than you ever have before. You're going to feel so much better. You're going to notice every day that your self-confidence and your self-esteem is going to grow. You're going to think more about yourself. You're going to do better every day. Every beat of your heart, with every breath you take, every day, you're going to feel your self-confidence and your level going up and up and up. Every day you're going to feel better and better and better with every beat of your heart, with every breath that you take. Okay? So go ahead and sit up straight up in your chair for me. What I'm going to do now, my friend, we appreciate you coming up here. What we're going to do, well, I want you to take these positive suggestions with you when you leave this building for the rest of your life, every day to feel better and grow self-confidence and feel better. And enjoy getting a good night's sleep tonight and waking up refreshed. So that's our gift to you for coming up and volunteering. So what we're going to do now is we're going to bring you back out of hypnosis, back to the current day, back to Winter Circle, where you feel refreshed, where you feel so much better, you have more energy, you're going to be smiling. You know, for one thing, you may or may not remember everything that you've done, but when everything is mentioned, you're going to remember everything that happened. And you're going to remember mainly that you enjoyed it, you feel so much better, and you have fun. So at the count of five, I'm going to bring you out of hypnosis. At the count of five, your eyes will be open. You'll be back alert, back to our current date and time. One, feeling so much better. Two, having a greater self-confidence, self-esteem in yourself, not only tonight, but every day of your life, with every beat of your heart, with every breath you take, feeling better, more confident, stronger, and happier. Three, feeling confident, feeling better, knowing that tonight that you had fun, knowing that everybody enjoyed watching you, that you weren't embarrassed, and you had a great time, and you reaped and enjoyed the benefits of hypnosis. Number four, your head's starting to lift, your eyes are starting to flutter, you're starting to come out of hypnosis, feeling better, feeling happier, and just being so happy and so much better. And five, eyes open, fully alert. Eyes open, fully alert, and this thunderous round of applause is for you.